Respected Ashwini Krishnamurty ji, the correspondent of this great college, the principal Sri Srinivas ji, and the former teacher Bhaskar ji, welcome here. I was told by Ashwini ji that you take a lot of interest, so you do not want to retire. I believe that none of us should retire. Thank you very much for being here. Clap, you can clap. Veena ji, the sutradhar who has connected all of us, and a very good lecturer. I have a lot of friends here in this premises. Mr. Ravi Kumar ji, you are hiding somewhere, I am not able to see you. Oh, what, there you are. And I have Anita ji. Thank you. All the faculty members, as I don't know you personally, in the next 1 hour we will get to know each other better, and after that we can have a cup of coffee after the session, then we'll know better. And all my makkal. Am I correct?
Yes.
Swalpa swalpa Kannada maatadtini. It is one of the sweetest language. If anybody tells me, then my favorite poet, you ask me also, I tell, it is poem. Oh, Nanna Chetana Aguni Aniketana. That is my favorite poem. So when we take up today's topic, rejuvenation of young mind. In fact, we always say that we want to develop the personality of every individual. You are able to understand me? You are understanding me?
Yes.
I am telling in simple English. In case somewhere you are stuck, don't hesitate to ask me back. Okay? No country in the world can prosper or develop without giving the responsibility to the younger generation. I am 65 now. If I sit in my chair and say, I don't want a wicket because I am healthy and the youngster has to wait till I die, then this country will lose the energy, because after my death, by the time that person will come to occupy, he is also about 50 years. So what is happening is, the age is a very important factor to keep the physical energy active. All of you are very young. Lot of enthusiasm, lot of energy is there. So only thing here you have to understand is, you have to believe yourself. You have to believe yourself. Do you believe yourself?
Yes.
Do you?
Yes.
What I see is, voice is coming from this side, girls, not from boys. Boys, do you believe yourself?
Yes.
This is like voice. And now, when you say you believe yourself, then my work becomes very easy. When you start with a concept in your mind that you believe yourself, and whatever you do, it will be a project that you will take throughout your life till the end. Now, what is the project of your life? You have to understand that each one of you are born as a different individual. The body may look same. The hands may be there same. The legs may be same. The eyes may be same. Maybe the brain also, from a distance as a covered head, will look very same. But inside, there is a different personality. Every body contains an extraordinary personality inside. Hence, if you want to do anything in your life, you have to identify that uniqueness exists in you. That extraordinary unique quality that exists in you. Now I will tell you how humans has identified the unique quality. At the beginning, the first humans when they are born, you know what happened? They were like animals. And many of you are aware that we belong to, along with animals, we are a mammal family. We are not separate. We are also animals. What is the difference between those animals and us? There is a very simple difference between those animals and us. That simple difference is the intellectual ability that humans have got. We can think, we can act. Whereas they think only limitedly. How much animal think? Food they want, they will hunt and eat food. If they want, you know, more food, they will hunt more and eat. And wherever they want, they will sleep. But if somebody is attacking them, they will go and fight. Is it not the nature of animal? Am I right?
Yes.
Are you following me?
Yes.
So when this is the nature of animal, so also the nature of man is also same. Animals have an inbuilt requirement called hunger. And another requirement of animals is fear. Fear of being attacked. Fear of being killed. So they always try to defend themselves. At their own, when they are hungry only, they will look for their own prey and they will find out those smaller animals than themselves and kill and eat. Though they are hungry, say a fox is hungry, it will not hunt elephant. Can they hunt? They cannot, because one stroke of elephant will make the fox sleep forever. So also the lion, such a big animal, but it cannot hunt an elephant. It cannot hunt a hippopotamus. It cannot hunt a rhino. So the entire concept of hunting is there limited to their requirement of eating. Right? That one time, in the era of human civilization, humans and animals were together. Can you believe a 3 years cub of a lion, when he hits with his claw, the stroke's weight is 3 ton. 3 ton. You just cannot imagine 3 ton a hit here. Spot, humans will die. So that is the capacity of a 3 years cub. What will happen when the 5 years lion is there in front of your 8 years lion is there? So very strong. So the animals were very powerful. The snake was very powerful. The cobra in the snake's family. So also the cat family, the tiger, the leopard, everybody is powerful. So also the elephant. So also the hippopotamus, so also the rhino, and various other animals including fox, they were all powerful than human being. That was a time when humans made efforts. That was a time when human opened their mind. That was a time when the human understood that if I live with these animals, whatever they are killing and eating, little leftover they are throwing at my face and we are eating. There is no individual life for us except eating this whatever available in the, what you call is, fruits. They were yet to identify which are the genuine fruit which they have to eat, which grass they should eat, which kind of, you know, items they should eat. They were not very clear. Then the man thought. The first human started thinking. And that is the beginning of a process of human intellectual development and evolutionary process started. From animal instinct, the man started behaving like an intelligent personality. That's the first beginning. And in that first beginning, one day, the human were playing with the stones. And when that stones were come in contact with each other, suddenly the spark came. And that's the beginning of discovery of fire. They discovered the fire. Once the man found fire, With that fire, they found suddenly lot of dry grasses, dry leaves there started burning. They did one time, two times, three times, four times. When that fire started really burning, they found lion is not coming. The elephant is staying away. The fox is not coming near. The snakes are running away. They found all animals leaving them, and he suddenly found that he is very strong because he has fire in his hand. That was the first human discovery of a big weapon. So from nothing, they discovered something. They had nothing with them, and they discovered something. And that something became their first weapon, and they started one after another controlling the entire forest. And then they realized, why should they sleep on this? So they cleaned the place. Then they were naked. The moon, men, women made no difference. Everybody was having, you know, like animals they were living. Then at that time they realized that they should cover themselves. Then they took the best leaf available, the bigger leaves, and they covered themselves. Then they said, why should leaf? They get, you know, they are not static. They get torn off very easily. So they decided, let us take the best skin of the animals and tie us up. So they started selecting the design skin. So they started killing tiger, leopard, and they used to wear that skins. So till that moment, the weakest among the animals was the man. Till that moment, weakest among the animals was human being. And that weakest human being became the strongest one. And from there began the journey of the great human intellectual evolutionary process. And it went to such an extent that today, you all know that we make animals dance at our tune. Is it not? Have you seen in circus?
Yes.
That we bring the lion and we tell him, stand up, sit down, go there, come here, jump there, do this, do that. We make monkey do all kind of tricks. We bring horse, we make him do all tricks. So these all control started coming over the entire world. The human became very powerful. Then it started thinking, "Arey, I have my woman. I must give him a better life." So he constructed the house. That is, first he constructed with all that grass was available there. You know, the grass is available there. Whatever the trees, dries, twigs were available, with that he made a hut. Then he used to strengthen that. He used the earth, that is the mud available there, and he plastered with that. Then he realized mud, and when the cow dung is mixed, it becomes very strong. Then one day he was digging, he found lime. So he said, lime also is mixed, it will much better. So went on and went on and went on and went on and went on, and the discovery after discovery they continued. From the sugar cane they made jaggery, and from the jaggery they mixed it in lime. When jaggery and lime is mixed, the walls became very strong, very cool inside, and there was no problem. So the first of the houses were mandava houses. They were made with such elements, such intellectual clarity, that those houses had the sunlight coming inside. Straight away, the moment the sun comes in the horizon, the light comes inside the hall. If you go and see those mandava houses anywhere, you will find there is a nice filtration for light to come inside. The knowledge evolved. They started growing. They started learning very quickly. They learned from everything in the nature. They picked up all the good things and they made a syllabus for themselves. They made a curriculum for themselves, and then started the process of human growth. They mastered the sea. They mastered the sea. They mastered the earth. Initially they were going by walk. Then what they did? They used bullock cart. Right? They started climbing on those animals which can be tamed. So they were sitting on the buffalo, they were sitting on the donkey, they were sitting on the, you know, those animals which are softer by nature. They used to sit on them and move from one place to another like fast. Then they realized, aisa kuch nahi hai, let us start speed. Then they constructed the first cart. From that, they made a horse to drive their cart, and the speed era started. That is why for every engine or a motor, you understand this, engine or a motor, in a car there is an engine, you have a motor at your home which pumps the water, In every place, they started using the word called horse power. What is the power?
Horse.
Because the most fastest moving animal they found is horse, which has a tremendous energy and tremendous speed. So the entire armature and winding technology was devoted to horse power. So this development started. And this development went on and went on and went on. Today, man is traveling from one place to the other in a matter of no time. From Mangalore to Mangalore, we travel in 50 minutes by air. 50 minutes only. From here to Delhi, we travel in 2.5 hours. From here to England, we are traveling in 8 hours to 9 hours. From here to USA, that is New York City, we are traveling in 12 hours. From here, we are traveling to any part of the world over a flight in no time. Am I right? Are you understanding?
Yes.
Similarly, the human evolutions continued and continued and continued. Then they discovered what is under the sea. Then they discovered what is the things that can get from the air. They discovered what is the thing they can get from the under the earth, what is their metals, what are the minerals that is available, what are the combination of chemicals they can make, what are the fermentation they can create, and there were one discovery of science after another, and it went on and went on and went on and went on. For all these things, do you know, India is a great player in this, because we were the first people in the world to have a university of our own. Do you know that? Okay, you can clap. Continue. Now you tell me. Answer me. Do you know the first university of the world? The name of that university? Anyone? The first Indian university name is Takshashila. The second name is Nalanda. These both are the same universities that brought laurels to this country. The greatest came to this country because the worldwide students started coming to India and studying. Especially the Asians started coming to India to learn. The Chinese used to come, the Japanese used to come, the Korean used to come, the people from different parts of the world, they used to come. At that time there was no country like Pakistan, Afghanistan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Nepal. They were all in Akhanda Bharat. They were part and parcel of this great country. Hence, there were less people coming from these parts. They were already Indians and they used to come and study in the university. So the capacity to study in the university was extraordinary. And when they came here, each of the lecturers, each of the professors were called Acharya. The professor who has a post-graduation in his hand, they used to be called Acharya. And the one who was teaching at the graduation level, who has got a qualification of graduation, they were known as Shastri. What a graduation is known as?
Shastri.
What a post-graduation is known as?
Acharya.
So today I stand here as a post-graduate in front of you as Acharya. Lal Bahadur Shastri, our first Prime Minister. Many people mistake that he is a Brahmin. He is a backward class born man. Shastri is his degree graduation, which many people don't know. Shastri is for graduation. Acharya is for post-graduation. So the human evolutionary process continued. We went inside the sea. We digged it everything. We found it, what is pearls. There were a lot of storage things that is there. A lot of knowledge sea gave us. Ocean was full of, you know, great things inside. Then when humans thought, if we are going as a human, we have to hold our breath and go there and come back. It takes less time for us to stay inside. So they invented, what they invented? What they invented to stay inside the sea? Inside. What they invented? Anybody, one person, please. Say loudly, one. They invented submarine to stay inside. The ship travels outside, but the submarine stays inside. And they went inside and they started making research and investigation that what is there in the sea. They found great things like octopus. Have you heard of octopus? Octopus has got 10 tentacles. That is God's greatest creation, though. One of the creation is that a particular animal or a particular reptile can have 10 hands. It can deal at a time 10 hands. So you should believe the Ravana also had 10 heads. It is the process of creation, it was there. The human intellectual continually evolved. We control the sea, we control the air, we control the, what you call, under the sea, and we control under the earth, and we created many bunkers. So human intellectual born from nothing to everything. From no bed, no family, to they got to bed, house, nice house, air conditioned house, and they went on. Now they have a smartphone. They have a digital technology. That they sit here and your picture is gone to New York immediately. The evolutionary process is continuing. So why I told you this entire story is, the first human was animal. The present human is the most intelligent who controls the animals. What a difference. Once we were fearing the animals, today we control the animals. In circus, if you have seen, there will be a stick with the hand of the ringmaster. That stick has a very specialized thing, you know. It will have 12 volt battery, and the moment it comes in contact with an animal, it gives a shock, electrical shock. That electrical shock makes the animal fear. Whenever he takes an air, automatically the lion is tamed. He will do, because he gets angry, you are giving him a shock treatment. You should see in the circus and observe. So also such a big elephant, they created one ankusha. Just take, hit, elephant is tamed down. The human brain is the most superior thing that is available in this world. So you accept that you have brain?
Yes.
Do you have brain?
Yes.
Do you have a brain?
Yes.
Do you understand the brain?
Yes.
Now I will tell you how our Rishi Munis have evolved. The world was always doing something which they were not knowing. Except India. Except a bit of China. Except a bit of Parisian people. Rest all were unknown to many facts. So like, you know, people in England, imperial countries, and the NATO countries, you know what they used to do? One, two, buckle my shoe. What they used to do? One, two, one, two, three, four. You know, these idiots in imperial Western countries, they have no brain. Our brain was superior. I'm telling idiot. Idiot is not a slang. Idiot means person with more ignorance, who do not have knowledge. Indians had knowledge. These fellows were doing one, two, three, four, five, six. They struck at seven, eight. Nine, ten, what they do? Because they have no zero, so there is no ten. They stuck at nine. Their entire system got shut at one, two, buckle my shoe, three, four, shut the door, five, six, seven, eight. And after that, they don't have nine, ten. They have stuck at nine. When they got the ten? When India gave them zero. Aryabhat, the greatest of India's evolutionary brain, the great scientist, he gave the world zero and also decimal. Once you put a decimal, the infinite system runs. What is infinity? Let us talk about infinity. Let us understand how the human brain works. 10 into 10? 10 into 10?
100
into 100? 100 into 100? 1,000 into 1,000? Huh? 1 lakh into 1 lakh? This the world was not knowing. They were not knowing what to do. They were only doing 2 into 2, 4. 9 into 9, 81. They were struck at 81 then. If India would have not been there. So we are the best brain in the world. When this was given, then the calculation, multiplication started. then they came up to 9, 10. What is 9, 10? Forget it. I am not going to tell you. You have to tell. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 9, 10, 0. Hey, where is the hero? Where is that hero who tells about the zero? Very, very funny guy. Who is he? Give him a big clap. Now identify who is he. Who is he? Identify him. Catch him now. Make him stand. Who is he? Get up. What's your name?
Rajwal.
Oh, you are Rajwal. Oh, great. Give him a big clap. Sit down, Rajwal. That's so nice of you. So we coined the zero, then the, now you look at the fun. See, they could write 9, they don't know how to write 19, because zero is not there. They can't write. So we gave them zero, they wrote 90, they wrote 900, they wrote 9000, they wrote 9 lakhs, they wrote 90 lakhs. And they went on like that, 90 crores, like that. So zero made the whole difference to entire mathematics, entire science, entire calculation. That is why the countries which don't have a knowledge of zero, they were telling their hero, actually we are hero, they are zero. So this is the catch. The human brain. The power of the human brain, the intellectual capability of human brain is extraordinary. All our makhlus are very intelligent. Super. So my sincere appeal to you is, now you should understand how the brain works. How to make your life better, best and the best. How can you make yourself change? What is the most important factor that today we are going to learn? Our great seers who used their brain. How did they develop their brain? Please concentrate on me. That brain they developed with a very, very high precision understanding of human body. So when they used to sit in meditation, they used to do an extraordinary thing. In the meditation where their eyes is closed, inside their brain, new things used to appear. Those new things, when they complete their meditation, they used to write down in a talapatra. So they were very smart. So what they did, they understood that whatever they could visualize during the meditation, that they converted into a script. Those are the scientific script today we have in the world, which is used for all discoveries. They calculated everything. There were great, great teachers and saints. One of the great teacher and saint was Varahamihir. Varahamihir was a great scientist. One I told you is Aryabhatta. These scientists have discovered various things. We had one more great scientist those times called Parashara. These are the great Rishi Munis who discovered the entire cosmic world, entire earth, whatever is there in the world. They calculated the distance between one planet to another. They discovered everything and put it in a black and white paper. That was in Talapatra Gandha. So my sincere appeal to you is, please understand that your brain needs to be sharpened. When your eyes you open and see, your eyes are open now?
Yes.
You are able to look at me?
Yes.
You are able to look at me?
Yes.
You are continually seeing my face?
Yes.
Tell me my nose is here or here? Where is my nose?
Yes.
In the front?
Yes.
Right. Now you close your eyes. You tell me, are you breathing now?
Yes.
Have you seen your breath?
No.
Have you seen your breath? What you have not seen is giving you life. Am I right?
Yes.
What you have not seen
You cannot see the breath, no? Okay, now open your eyes and see the breath and tell me. Come on now. Can you see?
No.
So you cannot see the breath with open eyes. You cannot see with closed eyes. What you can do? You can feel. What you can do?
Feel.
You are feeling that you are breathing. Your feeling is very important because your feeling gives you guidelines that you are breathing at this moment. Am I right?
Yes.
You understood now?
Yes.
So closing your eyes, your natural instinct will not get destroyed. Your ability to contemplate will not get destroyed. Your ability to understand anything will never get destroyed. It will increase. Now close your eyes and visualize your mom. See your mom in closed eyes. Close. Close your eyes. Close your eyes. Close. Aankh band karo sir. After closing the eyes and you see your mommy. You see your amma?
Yes.
Are you able to?
Yes.
You know how she looks like? Right?
Yes.
Today what color of sari she is wearing? Which color of burqa she is wearing? Are you able to see?
Yes.
So now visualize your father. Are you able to see him?
Yes.
Now you visualize your brother. Now you visualize your sister. Open your eyes. Similarly, when you close your eyes, if every day you practice for 30 minutes, meditation. This is one of the most important part of Swadhyaya. Swadhyana. When you start learning yourself, you have to close your eyes, keep your mind very sharp, so that when you open your eyes, you can just like a magnet, you can catch the picture. Got my point? You should not chant any name of the God. You should actually, during the meditation, keep your mind silent. When you are silent, the brain will not allow you to be silent, it will be violent. You know why? It will suddenly, your teachers will come in front of you in the brain. She will be telling, you have not taken the grammar properly in English, mathematics you are not having. Oh. Hey children, you should not go for playing now, get in the classroom. The teachers will come. Then mom will come. Tu aaj ghar aana, agar tere ko 10 pe 10 nahi aata to dande maar. So during meditation, so many negative things will come in your mind. And it will run around inside. How to handle that negative things? Look at that inside without opening eyes. Then it will disappear. It will disappear. Give attention to the negative aspect, it will disappear. The moment teacher comes, English will kick. Yes, teacher, I will do it. If you say inside, the teacher will go. Teacher wants a promise. Teacher doesn't want to beat you. Teacher wants you to be the best. Teacher doesn't want to harm you. So once that your attention he has given, she is very happy. Yes, yes, she will do it. Now he is doing this meditation for 30 minutes. Now close your eyes and he is doing this meditation for 30 minutes. Then initially it looks very difficult because so many other thinkings come. But as you start doing this practice every day morning at 5 a.m. up to 5:30 if you can do, I can tell you, whichever subject you don't know, within 6 months in that subject you will start getting 30-40% improvement. So today I have taken this time to tell you that your brain is the best. Your brain has the capacity to unravel great secrets of nature. When you discover the secrets of nature, you become Einstein. When you discover the natural secrets, then you become Abdul Kalam.
When you discover these secrets, you become Satish Dhawan. When you discover these secrets, you know how intercontinental ballistic missile functions. You will understand how a Brahmos missile functions. You will understand when you go into meditation deep that how the knowledge existed inside the earth, above the earth, in the air, in the sea, in everywhere. Have you seen a non-vegetarian plant? Have you seen any non-vegetarian plant? Do you know that any botany lecturer is here? Botany lecturer is here? Sir, anybody botany? Thank you, sir. Ravi Kumar, you're botany, huh? Oh my God, that's great. So there is a plant where if you go near that plant and put the hand in the flower, your entire flesh will be eaten away. Such excretion of acids are there. There is a different type of plant available. You will be surprised, there is a bird which can just by hitting it on the tree, it can make a big hole. You have to discover the greatness of nature. That what is the substance in the beak of that particular bird which is not there in other birds. So zoology, botany, all this is a discovery of knowledge. There are dicot plant, there are monocot plant, there are orthopoda, family. You have to go on understanding these things, you will find many things. But your brain should find out what you like. You may like something, then you start investigation on that. You start questioning that. In that particular process, you should move step by step. Supposing you don't know something, you have to ask. Whom you will ask? Whom you will ask? Whom you will ask?
Teachers.
You can ask parents, you can ask teachers, you can ask a group of teachers, and you can ask your fellow student also, colleague also, your friend also. Questioning is your right. You can always ask a question, but do not question the knowledge of your teacher. Very clear. Tadvidhi pranipatena pariprasnena sevaya. What is pariprasnena sevaya? What you don't know, you can ask, but pariprasnena sevaya. Vyas Maharishi should not have used the word pari, he should have used tadvidhi pranipatena prasnena sevaya, he didn't say. He said pariprasnena sevaya. Why did he say that? Pari means you cannot question the knowledge of the teacher. But you can question what you don't know, teacher will tell you. Never test the teacher. Never. That is not in your domain. That is not within the authority you are having. You can ask. You can ask how many questions you ask your mom. Kitne question bolte hai? Puchte rehte hai. Mom, ye kya hai? Wo kya hai? Mom, wo kya hai? See, you go on asking. Because you don't know you are asking, because you don't know, you have a right to ask. And the greatest of learning process happens for a student is when you ask. You ask something, then it is easy for me to tell. The other day one child asked me in the college that, sir, is there anything called future? What is future? What is future? Is it there? You tell me, is there any future? Please tell me, is there any future in this world? Huh? Is there any future? You are not understood. You are not yet answering clearly. Is there any future? Is there any future? Yesterday you came to school?
Yes.
Yesterday you went to the college?
Yes.
You did?
Yes.
Yesterday was present or future or past?
Past.
How can it be yesterday past? When you were there in the classroom yesterday, it was a present. What did I register? So, past, sir? Sir, it shows past? What it shows? Yesterday, in your attendance register, what it is showing, present or past? Present or past?
Present.
What it is showing today, present or future? Tell me what it is showing today in the attendance register, present or future?
Present.
What it will show tomorrow?
Present.
What it will show tomorrow? Answer me, don't worry.
Present.
Yesterday was present, today is present, tomorrow is present. What you didn't do today, there is no future tomorrow. Kala kare so aadikar, aadikare so am, paime parlai hoega, paura kareja ka. Whatever you have to do, you just pre-pone things and start doing. Don't wait for another tomorrow. Because there is no tomorrow for anybody. In one shop it is written, one kirana shop. In childhood I used to go to buy some sugar, some dal or some salt or some onion or something. My mom used to send, I used to go to the shop. In that shop there is a board written. What is written, no? Today cash, tomorrow credit. What is written? Next day also I go, it is the same thing written. So, that tomorrow never comes, I never get the credit. Every day I have to pay cash. Understood?
Yes.
Life has no credit, life has no debit. It is only the present action, it is the action in cash. Understood?
Yes.
So today if you have not done your homework, today you have not done your work, today you are not studying, today you are not listening to your teacher, today you didn't work properly in your classroom, today you didn't practice your mathematics, today you didn't practice your football, today you didn't do your meditation, today you are not taking your food in proper time, then there is no tomorrow for you. Tomorrow you may fall sick. Because today you didn't do everything correctly. Am I right?
Yes.
You got to do everything right. You have to do everything systematically. And you have to do everything today, right now. Life is now or never. Life is now or never. Life is now or never. Now, my young friends, you should understand that life is continuously changing. You are today small kids. You've grown up as young boys and girls, then you become a middle-aged person, and then you become old like me, and we all depart from this world, the new generation we leave and go. So the process is from butterfly to caterpillar is not the process. The process is from caterpillar to butterfly. From 40 to 70, it is not 70 to 40. So there is nothing called past, there is nothing called future. It is called the present moment. If you do not perform in the present moment properly, and if you do not take care of yourself properly at this moment, then you will not be able to deliver many things in your life. So my question to all of you is, you have to now come to the final lap of my teaching. Today's lecture I am closing with the final law. Have you learned anything from the ant? Do you learn anything from ant? Do you learn anything from ant?
Yes.
What is that you learn from ant?
Unity.
Unity. Okay.
Hard work.
Hard work. Okay. Something more? Something more? Confidence. What else you learn? Don't you learn discipline? Ants are very disciplined. When this program is over, none of you will go in straight line to your classroom. You will just run out from here and get into rooms pushing each other. Don't you do that?
Yes.
Don't you do that?
Yes.
Don't you do that?
Yes.
That is indiscipline. And teaches us do everything in a disciplined fashion. Consistently do. Hard work is not the correct word. Here the hard work is coupled with intelligence. It does consistently its efforts. It keeps on working on what it is working. The small ant carrying a grain of rice, it tries to climb a wall, it slips and and yet it raises again and ultimately it crosses the wall. That's the way the ant teaches us. That's the way ant tells you that you have to perform consistently. You have to perform and on and on and on. There is nothing called what you did today will help you tomorrow. You have to do it every day. Do you brush your teeth every day?
Yes.
Do you take bath every day?
Yes.
Do you eat every day?
Yes.
So also, whatever you learn, you have to keep practicing it. Abhyasa yoga. You have to continuously do it. Have you understood?
Yes.
So you have to now understand that in your life there are many things that you want to do it. Then fix a goal for yourself. What you really want to do. You want to become a historian. You want to become an archaeologist. You want to become a sportsman. You want to become a cine actor. You want to be a doctor. You want to be an engineer. Whatever you want to become, you have to really frame into your mind. Immediately you have to start thinking on that. Once you start visualizing here in your mind, then you have to put your efforts continuously like an ant does. Like an ant does. And you must believe in life that rose will have thorns. Don't try for any life in life that will be very free of all this problem. There is no such problem, life which is full of freedom. That is, you have seen for the eagle how it struggles. You have seen for already the caterpillar, it became butterfly. So everything has to struggle to evolve and to grow and become something independently. So fix a goal for yourself, work for your goal, plan that goal. If necessary come, debate the goal with your teacher, take his advice. Manasa, vacha, karmana, thought, word and deed. Whatever you think, you debate, you understand and then move forward. Understood?
Yes.
So can I say that I conclude now? Can I close now? Shall I continue?
Yes.
Shall I continue?
Yes.
Hey, 1.5 hour over already. You want to still enjoy?
Yes.
You are happy?
Yes.
You like this talk?
Yes.
Oh my God. Children, I have told you one Kabir Das proverb, you know, kal kare so aaj kare, aaj kare so av pal mein parlay hoega bahura kare. I have asked you to prepone the time. What did I ask you? Prepone. That means what you want to do tomorrow, please do it today. What you want to do it today, do it now. So why I told you that? Because you must value the time. 24 hours is given to everybody. An engineer gets 24 hours, a doctor gets 24 hours, a student gets 24 hours, a teacher gets 24 hours, a farmer gets 24 hours, a purohit gets 24 hours, a maulvi gets 24 hours, a church father gets 24 hours. Everybody in this world is given 24 hours. Same for everybody. Am I correct? But it depends how do you use that 24 hours. If you are going to live for 100 years, your total life span will be 37,500 days. 37,500 days only you will have a life. Out of that you are spending your time by sleeping. When you sleep, 40 to 50% time goes in sleep. Rata gamai soi ke divas gamai khai. Hira janma molta kaudi badale jai. The life is worth a diamond. It goes off night time in sleep and daytime watching TV, gossiping, not concentrating on anything. So you waste your time. Please don't do that. So 37,500, you will be losing 50% means you are left over with how much? Hardly 17,000 days. In 17,000 days, what are you going to do? If you take bath in the morning, you brush your teeth, you change your dress, you do all kind of things, you lose almost 4 hours a day. And if you calculate these 4 hours, in terms of 100 years of life you live, you will be losing almost about another 7 to 8 years. 8 years is gone that way.
50%, that is 17, what you call, out of 100 years you have got 50 years, you lost 58 years is gone in sleeping, and now balance 12 years in childhood when you are not responsible, you don't listen to anybody, you always love playing, you enjoy everything, and 12 years like me in the old age when we want to do everything but we cannot do anything because the body do not permit us, our time do not permit us, our age do not permit us. So 12 plus 12, 24 plus 50 in the sleep, 74 gone out of 100, and 8 gone in bathing and getting ready and makeup and every other damn thing. So you are hardly left with 10 to 12 years of life, provided you live 100 years. If you live 80 years, according to the calculation of 33%, you have to only calculate. That means if you live 80 years, you will get less time. If you live 60 years, you will get further less time. That is why, please manage your time well. Time and tide will wait for none. You have seen in the sea, when the waves come, can you stop that? It waits for none. It will come up and it will disappear. It will come up and it will disappear. So time is your precious asset, and you should always believe that the bungalow, that the car, the property you built up is going to help you nothing. But if you built up your mind, you built up knowledge, you built up wisdom, then it will give you the best of the best life. Because all the rich people in the world are always forgotten after their death. But all the people who are intelligent, who are smart, who did everything for the world, they were not rich, but they were intelligent. Abdul Kalam, a great Indian Muslim who has done a great contribution to thousands of people, lakhs of people, crores of people in this country, and ultimately he did a great favor to the world by discovering many things. He is the one who discovered a stent for the heart at low cost. He discovered a caliper for the, those who had this polio affected children. For them, it was earlier 3.5 kg weight was the caliper. Today, it is 300 grams. It was his discovery. All this great thing, Abdul Kalam could do it because he was not financially rich. He was intellectually rich. He will never be forgotten as long as the human world exists. As long as this India is there, we will all remember him. But we have forgotten all those cinema actors, all those people who did some jantar mantar in life, who made some money, who constructed big bungalows and gone forever. No one remembers rich people. Money is never remembered. Money should be last priority in our life. Our first priority should be knowledge acquisition. Knowledge acquisition only can make people great, and those people who have acquired knowledge, they all become great people in the world. And that, if you want a list of people, I can tell you one after another. Abraham Lincoln, he has acquired knowledge. That's why he became a great man. Knowledge is not a degree. Knowledge is not a certificate. Knowledge is not somebody telling you that you are a postgraduate or a graduate. Knowledge is something great, something different, something class. Einstein didn't go to any university, but still he was the best scientist. Thomas Alva Edison didn't go to any university, but he was a great scientist. So also Rabindranath Tagore didn't go to any school or college, but he was a Nobel laureate in literature. So this all world over, if you see the phenomena, knowledge is something superior to any other thing in this world. So my suggestion to all my young friends, my future prime minister, future scientist, my future great people for this country, you are going to make India great. That is my belief. Will you do it? The tip number one, dream has to be converted into goal. The difference between dream and goal, goal is time-bound, dream is a hallucination. Whatever we do in our life, we have to continuously do it, consistently do it. So consistency is very important. Determination is very important. We need to do intelligent hard work, that is called smart work.
We should always be disciplined. And we should never have fear of anything. Because this body is perishable. It is a rented accommodation. We have come under a lease contract with this body. Once the lease period is over, we will go away. We will leave the body and go. So your affection towards the body should be lesser than required. Jada makeup mat karo, jada powder mat lagao, jada spray mat maro, kuch fayda nahi. Lekin daily take bath. You can apply soap to keep yourself fresh and get fragments. But you must always remember that life is most beautiful. One more quote, madam. You can note down, there is no competition in this world. You are competitor to your own self. Set a benchmark for yourself and compete. I give you an example of a sportsman. A sportsman runs, athlete runs 100 meter in. World record is 9.5 seconds. The national record is 11 seconds of India. But your college record is 26 seconds. The first boy who does in your college or a first girl who does 26 seconds or 25 seconds. But the second, third, you should not feel that you are doing a great thing, you are a first in the college. It is good to just get a clap, but clap is very dangerous. Claps are very dangerous, they misguide you. Your benchmark should be 9.5 seconds of international. You have to reduce by practicing every day from 26 seconds. You have to come down in 3 months to 22, 21, 19, 18, 16. Like that you have to 14, 13. Then come to national mark 11 and from there you go to 9.5. Then only you are successful. Never compete 26 seconds with 24 seconds because you will only be shuttling between failures. You will never enjoy the success. So please teach the children not to compete with each other. They should compete with a benchmark, a parameter which can make them enrich and take them to higher standards of evolutionary process. God bless you, my children. Sakala saubhagya siddhirastu. Sarva manovancha siddhirastu. May you all take India to greater heights, and I look forward for a great India after we depart from this world. Yet India will be the top country in the world and we make it a Vishwa Guru. So Bharat Mata Ki
Jai!
Bharat Mata Ki
Jai!
Bharat Mata Ki
Jai!
Thank you very much. Thank you. So kind of you.
Good morning to all. This is a valuable day for all of us. English matanadavaru buddhivantaragiddare, kannada matanadavaru hridayavantaragiddare. Adrinda, sir, sorry, ಇವತ್ತಿನ ದಿನ ಇಡೀ ಭಾರತವನ್ನು ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು, ಇಡೀ ಕಾಲೇಜನ್ನು ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಒಂದು ಕಾಮರ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅಥವಾ ಒಂದು ವಿಜ್ಞಾನ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅಥವಾ ಒಂದು ಆರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅಥವಾ ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು, ಯಾವುದೇ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಯನ್ನು ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಬ್ಬ ಮಾನವನ ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ಒಂದು ಚೇಂಜಿಂಗ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಇರ್ತದೆ, ಒಂದು ಟರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ಬಹುಶಃ ಆ ಟರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇವತ್ತೇ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು. ಭಾರತವನ್ನು ಕಟ್ಟುವವರು ನಾವು. ಭಾರತವನ್ನು ಕಟ್ಟಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬುನಾದಿ ಹಾಕಿರುವಂತದ್ದು ಗುರುಜಿಯವರು. ಅವರ ಮಾತುಗಳನ್ನು ಇಷ್ಟು ಹೊತ್ತು ಆಲಿಸಿದ ನಾವು ಏನಾದರೂ ಒಂದು ಸಾಧಿಸಲೇಬೇಕು, ಸಾಧಿಸಿ ತೋರಿಸಲೇಬೇಕು, ಸಾಧಿಸಿ ತೋರಿಸಲೇಬೇಕು. ಜನರಿಗೆ ದೇವರ ಮೂಲಕ್ಕೆ ಒಂದು ಪರ್ಯಾಯ ಪದ, ಪರ್ಯಾಯ ಮನುಷ್ಯ ಇದೆ. ನೀವೇ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಗಳಿಗೆ ಒಂದು ಸವಾಲ್ ಎಸ್ತೇನೆ. ದೇವರನ್ನು ನೋಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ನಾನು ಇವತ್ತು ದೇವರನ್ನು ನೋಡಿದ್ದೇನೆ. ಯಾಕಂತ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸತ್ಯಗಳು ಹೊರಗೆ ಬರುವಾಗ ವಿಜ್ಞಾನ ಬಂದದ್ದು. ಹಾಗೆ ದಾಹ ಆದಾಗ ನೀರಿನ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ, ಹಸಿವೆ ಆದಾಗ ಅನ್ನದ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ತಿಳಿಯ ತಿಳಿಯದೆ ಇರುವಾಗ ಅಂಧಕಾರದಲ್ಲಿರುವಾಗ ಬೆಳಕಿನ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬರುವಲ್ಲಿ ದೇವರು ಅಂತ ಇವತ್ತು ನಾನು ನಂಬುತ್ತೇನೆ. ಅದರಿಂದ ನಮಗೆ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿರುವಂತಹ ದೇವರು ಅವರು ಅವರ ಮಾತುಗಳನ್ನು ನಾವು ಹಿಂಬಾಲಿಸಬೇಕು. ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅವರತ್ತೆ ಮುಂದೆ ನಮಗೂ ಒಂದು ಮೋಟಿವೇಶನ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಕೊಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕು. ಅಷ್ಟು ಪವರ್ಫುಲ್ ಆಗಿ ನಾವು ಮುಂದುವರಿಬಹುದು. ನಮ್ಗೆ ಇಷ್ಟು ಹೊತ್ತು ಒಂದು ಮೋಟಿವೇಶನ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟದಕ್ಕೆ ಗುರುಜಿ ಅವರಿಗೂ ಹಾಗೂ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಕೇಳಿಸಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಹಾಯ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಕ್ಕೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾಮರ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ನ ಮೇಡಮ್ ವಿನಾ ಟೀಚರ್ ಹಾಗೂ ಅದರ ಹಿಂದೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಎಲ್ಲ ಅಧ್ಯಾಪಕರಿಗೂ ಪ್ರಾಧ್ಯಾಪಕರಿಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ವಂದನೆಗಳು. ಇಷ್ಟು ಹೇಳಿ ನನ್ನ ಒಂದೆರಡು ಮಾತುಗಳನ್ನು ಮುಗಿಸುತ್ತೇನೆ. ಜೈ.